Okay, I think there was a question actually. Once the database is installed, how to check whether it is completed successfully or not? So you have to log in and then see. If you are able to successfully log into database, you can see. If you are completely new people, so just to easily find out, this you can type out. Let's say SQL plus, go to command prompt, SQL plus, and then give your user's card, and then generally database name, and then so you can give in n number of ways, but you can just type it, it will. So now SQL plus means client, and this card is a username, @orcl orcl is database name. Maybe when you are installing database, what is the database name I have given, that is the database name, and forward slash and then password. So if you are able to log in means your database installation is right. So my system oversale will not be there. My system Apple will. So you will be in a position to see this. Then you are able to connect, further you will connect. Or else you will go to SQL developer and then login. Now coming back to ODI, so we have created repository master and work, and master is there and work repository both are present, and we have created a login. So right now I'm trying to login with master and work as a combination. Say okay. Power 8:30. Okay, so now back, any questions let me know, because we have first created in topology, it is all connectivity. Okay, first of all we have to establish connectivity to the databases from where you are planning to read or load, so that is all will be there in topology. So since our tables presently we are looking either reading or loading from Oracle database, and initially that from Scott, so I have created a database data server, so I have picked up Oracle, and we have created a data server. This will point you to our my database Apple or OverSale, whatever is the whatever Oracle database you have. Given username, password, given drivers, step 1, and this is only one time activity. Once you give, you can forget about, you don't need to regularly do this. Second, under this database, from whichever schemas you are planning to read the or load the data. Right now I am planning to read data from Scott schema, that is nothing but Scott user. So I have created a schema here. I have given a reference to that one. So it is a Scott because I am planning to read. In the same way, if you want to read data from multiple schemas, I have a Scott, I have a BA sample, I have a BA SH, BA XV, ABC. So under this database, you can create one more schema also in case you have to read from multiple. Because all schemas under the same database, you can create n number of schemas here. Okay, done. So once we have done this schema creation, whatever schema we have created in the physical, anything which we create under physical architecture, if you remember, if you see, everything I am doing in a palette which is, or a tab which is physical architecture. I just started from the physical architecture. Under physical architecture, this is the technology, and this is the data server and schema. This is called physical schema. This is called physical data server, because everything is under physical. So anything which you are calling always prefix physical, physical, physical. Once your physical schema is established and created, now what is the next step? We have to go and then start reading tables. Because my purpose, why I am coming to ODI, so there are some tables I want to read and I want to load it. So database connection is there, schema information is there. The next what I need is table, what tables you want to read or load it. So now I want to make use of this schema. So this schema is nothing but Scott and which is available in Apple. To start this using the schema, using the schema directly not permitted in ODI. So generally other technologies will directly use it, but in ODI we cannot use this physical object which you have created in physical architecture. Means in bracket, physical schemas cannot be directly used. So why cannot use? There is a purpose that will be understanding at the end of the course, because right now it will confuse you. So that's why it is not recommended or not permitted to use physical schemas directly. We'll use it indirectly. How it is indirectly means, for every physical schema, so this is the physical schema. So if you really see what we have done so far, have a table, this is a database, actual database, and in this database we have a Scott schema. Okay, so I have given a link, so I have created a, this is the real one, database and Scott. So in ODI, in technology, in physical, what we have done? We have done first, what is the object we have created? Data server. So this data server is pointing to this database. Data server means it will just ask for what is your database name, okay, and to connect to this, what is the username password. Under this data server, we have created schema. And this schema I am calling as a physical schema. So this is pointing to this one. So this is pointing to the whole database. If you have one more schema here, I will create one more and link it. So this way, that information we have it. So the next is, in our Scott schema, we have tables. EMB table, DBT table and all we have. So next is, I want to start using these tables, because everything we have so far, everything done. So I can go and start using the tables or creating the tables and point it to this. I can direct, in other technologies we will do it, but in ODI we will not use this directly. Okay, for every physical schema which you have created, for that we have to create something called logical schema. Rather than you creating the table here directly, so I will create another object which is called logical schema. And I will use the table over here. The table will come here. Rather than directly using this, we will not use directly this. We will create another link to this physical schema, which is called a logical schema. And in between, to link both of them, there will be one, a broker, which is called context. So since you are a beginner, you will not understand this concept. There is a purpose. So what is the purpose of this, you will understand later. Till the time, only thing is, your focus should be on how to use this, that's all. In the next, maybe after couple of classes, we'll come back to this and then explain you how this works. Means physical schema will point to a object broker called context, and then this context will, this will be acting like a broker in between. And at end, this will be a very important interview question. Why this? What is this? What is this? Okay. So rather than we using this physical directly, I am going to create a link or mapping link to this physical, which is called logical schema, and to link both, there is a broker context. Okay. So now to do this, what I am going to do, you know, creation of things is very easy. Only understanding is with confusion. Okay. So that's why right now forget about the understanding. So take it blindly, because at end of the course, we'll come to know the real use of this one or why they have introduced this way. Okay. So now we have done with this schema. What is this physical schema? SCART. This is the box. Now I cannot use this directly, so I can only use this. So there is a IAS officer sitting, nobody can directly command me, there is a broker. So first you have to go here, and then your broker will help over here. In the same way, I cannot use this directly, I need to indirectly use it. So when you go, when you double click this physical schema, all this we have given, and when you go to context tab here, okay, initially it will be blank because we have not done anything, okay, and the moment, so right now just see this, it is blank. And also when you come down in physical architecture, whatever we have, in the same way if you come down, you will see something called logical architecture, physical, logical, and technology, and here also technology. And when you expand, same list you will get it. And also you will see same name by Oracle, but here nothing is there because it is, we have not done anything here. We have done only physical schema created here, that is this, and here everything you see blank. And when you expand this context, there is some name called global, we have not done anything, it is already there. And logical architecture, Oracle, so here you see we have created something, and here we have not created anything, and here we have something called global. Generally context means always think that it is a broker, mediator. Now I am coming here and clicking on a button here, add button. Immediately when you click on button, whatever context name is there here will be displayed here. Maybe we can create new ones also, that we'll see in a last classes when we are discussing this topic. So don't make any, very simple for you as a beginner. Create a physical schema, go to here, click on this button, you will see by name, ignore, because it is already there, I'm using. Then here in the logical schema, since as we discussed, this, for the everything, if you want to use, we need a link here. So I'm going to give this name over here. You can give any name. Since it is a logical schema, logical, I'm giving a name, Scott. You can give any name. Means for this one, this is the logical, and this is the global context, and this is the this one. So the serial, if you see, this map to this, and from there it is mapping to this. And if you notice, the moment when I give this name and then click on save button, so I just saved it. Now you can notice, if I come back, because it is already there, ignore it. And if I refresh it, now you can see whatever name I have given here, by that name there is one object created here. Where in the, we have not seen this one previously, logical Scott, whatever created, means now whatever I was expecting has been created. This is the already there we have created. Rather than using this, we'll create this, and this is already there, the link will be like this. Okay, this is one time, so physical, context, logical. So going further, you can forget remaining all. This piece you can forget. This all you can forget. If I want to use this anything, I will only use this one. It will go and internally link to that one. So till here only, I will talk about this. Later on, I will only talk about this. When I say this, means it is nothing but this. And the, when I say this, it is nothing but this and this one. That way indirectly we'll go on. So in topology, physical, and for that physical, we'll link it to the logical in between the context is there. That is this. Now that you can see here directly left side. We don't need to that will not come to the database here. If you make any changes in the database, that will not be reflecting here. That we have to get it again. We don't need to create, we can refresh it. That we'll see now. No, we don't need to change anything here because it is only connection, right? Linking, no table, nothing. Unless there is a change in the password, you are not supposed to come here because so far we have not seen any table, we have not seen only schema name, connection, username, password, and that. Unless there is a change in the username, password, and we don't need to come here. That's it, it's only one time active, first time, that's all. And only if there is a change in the password only, maybe you may have to come and then change it. Otherwise, it is a fixed. Once you create it, leave it, forget. That's why I'm going, I will not come to this again. This is one time activity and our work will be something else. We'll be doing that. Yeah, it is all admin. And also mostly this will be given to the scene because it is the admin and all configuration. So in ODI, we'll have a separate person, a senior person who will do all these things. Okay. So that's, but we should know this. Physical, logical, broker, context. Okay. So because going further, I will only use logical. Okay. So that's why here one of the easy way to create it, create a physical double click, just give that name. That's all. Technically, and when you are developing a code, is only 1 second job. Because I'll double click and give the name, it will create it. But the logical arrangement internally is physical, logical, and then context linkage. Anytime, even if you double click this, it will show you this is the logical. This logical is pointing to this one or a Apple's cart via global. Either this way or that way, they are in interconnected. Once this is interconnected, you are done. You are done with your topology. Unless you want to change anything or unless you want to create a new connection for a new database or file or XML, big data or a Teradata, we don't need to come here. This is one-time activity. So, physical architecture, we have created physical schema. And in the logical architecture, logical schemas are created. Both are interconnected from a word called context. And the default context, we have, it is there by name global. That is already there. Done. So, move it from here. So, once you are done, topology means meaning defining your prototype connections configurations. That's what topology. So now this all the topology whatever I design, develop or configure here is going to save under which repository? Master. Because yesterday if you remember after logging to master repository I'm able to see this activated. All whatever I have created I'm able to see this. That's why. So that's why this connection is common for everyone. If you are 100 writes, if the connection is common to everyone, you create once only. And everybody can make use of that. Okay, done. The next part is your actual. So from here onwards, your developer will come. Okay, so now have the connections ready established. And now the time is to talk about what are the tables you are planning to use. For reading or loading purpose. Because we have so far reached to this level, it will give only up to connection. But now I want to talk about what are the tables you are planning to use. That's why come to the designer. So this is all the developer and this all will go to work repository. Okay. So now the first tab, palette, if you see this is the projects, ignore it. Lot of things are there. We'll go one by one. And out of all these things, the first important thing which is called models. What is model means? We already discussed. What is data model? Modeling means designing your tables. Okay. So wherever model is there means it is talking about something called tables only. Okay. So now we have to design our tables or define our tables which are going to use it. Since your tables are already there, where here? And also we have discussed, for our ODA purpose, I have created two tables. Because I want to read data from this table and this table. So I need to, so these two tables are already present here. So these two tables I need to design here. These are the two tables, this is the employee and this is the. So we have only up to now we have reached to this level. So now we have to keep these tables here, design in ODI. So for that we need to go to models. This is the place where we'll keep our tables. So go to here and click say new model. Now again it will ask you. So you are planning to create models, fine, but tell me on which database, because in the topology I have created, you might have created n number of connections to Oracle, DB2, Teradata, because it depends on your need. But you have to decide from which database you want. Okay, because I can work on, because when data warehousing means we'll read data from 100 different types of the databases and then process the data. That's why I'm going to say, so you can give any name to this model. Okay, I'm going to give model as model Scott, because I'm going to use tables from Scott user. You can give any name. It will take some unique name from here, that is called code. Then it is asking, please choose your technology, means for which database, okay, you are planning to use this. I'm planning to use this for Oracle. So choose the name Oracle. Then immediately by the time, once you choose this technology, if you see logical, so as I told, we are not going to touch physical, we'll be only using the logical ones. Okay, so if you come down here, immediately it is showing whatever logical schemas created under Oracle technology. So I have not done anything, it is just giving the drop down list. So I am going to choose this one. So going further, from now onwards anything will be referred to this one only, means indirectly this. Okay, so I have chosen, so I want to get the tables for this card user, so this one, it is nothing but that one only. Then remaining all you can just leave it as it is. Okay, important is these two. Then click on save, immediately you can see a model created, some blank, nothing is there, fine. Now model is created, means whatever tables I am going to create here, for that I am going to give some area, so that is your model. So model created, and this model pointing to this, this will point to this, this way it will work. Then now time is to keep the tables which you want, because that is missing. So I want to place the table. The modeling means nothing but keeping the tables. So when you click on reverse engineer button, there is one button called reverse engineer. Maybe in IT industry, there will be two words will be key pairing, especially when you're talking about the models, tables, forward engineering and reverse engineering. What is forward engineering means, okay, constructing a new one is called forward engineering. Okay, means if I go and create a table in a database manually, let's say create table, XYZ and all, giving, constructing a table really. Okay, so that is called forward engineering, means I am going to create a table, I am going to construct a building. What is the reverse engineering means, if tables are already created and there, list of the tables or table names are there, using those tables and then putting somewhere, means getting the table definitions from the existing database is called reverse. Means rather than you are creating, you are all, somebody already created, I am using them, means reverse engineer. I am going to get that table's information from the database and then going to use in the other technologies. So right now we are in ODI, we are a third party to database. So we already have the tables created here. So here we have these tables, table names, structure, everything is there. So this table structure definitions, everything I am going to use or get over here. That's why it is named as a reverse engineer. So what I want that I need two tables, one for reading and then one for loading. The tables also we have identified here. This and this one. So whatever tables you are planning to get, so there are two ways to get these tables here. So first I am showing one method. Okay, click on reverse engineer and just go to mask here. Okay, means give the table name which you want to get over here. Then in the bottom, just remove this. What is this removal? So mostly I'll tell you one first mistake, or not a mistake actually, it is for beginners. And if I keep employee table example, this will be looking like this. What is first mask means what is the table you are planning to bring, and second line says characters to remove from the table alias. Say for example your table name is very big, let's say ABC underscore some big name is there. When you get the table name here, so generally to easily refer that name in ODI, for that we can give some alias name. So ODI will automatically help you to create that alias name if you need it. When it is creating the alias name, it is asking, so this is your table name. If it is big, tell me what are the characters you want me to remove from this table name. So if I do this, what happens? Your table name is EMP and then you are asking to remove EMP characters. So your name will be bad. So this will be the first mistake you will face or problem you will face, because generally people will use EMP. The moment when you give the name, it will be same. When you try to get, nothing will be there because there is no name for you. Okay. So that's why you don't need this unless your table names are very big. So every time try to remove this option, nothing, because there is no value for this one. So give your table name and then click on now reverse engineer. So what it is doing reverse, it went to the database and getting the complete table information, and then you see immediately. Okay, so now you can see the table name here, and then we'll come back to this table name again. So this is one way of getting the table names here. So there is another way. Okay, so better you can try this one. Okay, you don't need to try other topic, but I'm just showing there is also another way. If you go to select reverse engineering, just click on this select reverse engineering, and then you select okay all options. You can see here, or you can remove this option. Okay, so whatever mask you give, that is a pattern matching of your tables. Rather than you giving a table, just make it blank everything and then come back here, and then now it will show all the tables which are available in this schema. And here you can choose one by one. So what are all you want? In the top you will have a button. By default everything is selected, and if you select this, it will deselect everything. And now whatever table you want to bring, one or multiple, you can select on your own. It's called selective reverse engineering. First keep everything blank here, come here and then select this, this, this. If you select this, it will show existing table also, which is already there. If you remove this, it will not show the one here, which is SRC. So it is not important, just leave it. And I am going to remove all options. Then I am going to select this table and then click on reverse engine. So this is another way. If you don't remember the table name, it will give the list. You can select from here. That is also will get added over here. So this is that, this is the step we are doing right now. So the table has been left side added. Now I can close this model from the left side. You will see this. So we are topology here done. Designer, we have the models and this is the model. And within that we have these two tables. If you expand this, you will see the table names and all that information, column names, everything from here are. If you double click this table, it will show. Right side this table, what is the table name, okay, and this is your actual table name if you want to understand all these things. So this is the alias name which will be created when you are taking, if your table name is very big. What is the actual important for us is this. As long as this table name is same with the database, you are safe. And this you can keep anything, this you can keep anything. Okay, this is actual your table name. A lot of other things are there, we will come to know slowly. And attributes, okay, these are all columns, this is the length, okay. And in the same way, this table also you can find out. If you want to see that whether this table is now properly done so far everything, so right click and say view data. When you say view data, now it is connecting to this model. This model is connecting to logical. Logical connecting to physical. Physical connected to a database. All information we have. So when I say view data, it is going to this. This is your table. So when I click view data, it will go here. And then finally it will go here. And here you have 14 records. And it will show the data for you. So always remember when I import, when I say reverse engineer, only table structure will come here, data will not come. Data will still there on the database only, where here. Means here. My data is here actually. It is not in ODI. So when you say view data, it is going to that place and then getting the data and then showing it to you. So it ensures that your, it proves that your connection, everything is done. It's fine. Okay, so this is the second step. So now we have the databases, tables, everything. So like this, all the tables which are going to use, you keep it here, that's all. Now, your actual development starts now here. Why we have done all these things? I want to develop a program to read data from this table and load here. This we have taken as a simple case, but in complex I read from XML and keep in a Teradata, or I will keep from read from Oracle and then keep in big data. So that is all where it is. But to start with, this is one of the simple, we are reading from one table and then loading into one table using ODI. So that is actual development we are supposed to do now. So once we have done here models, then in the projects, this is the place where we develop actual ODI programs which we generally develop. So I'm going to create one project, so you can create a number of projects here. So I'm going to say new project. So this you can give any project name. Okay, I'll say HR dev. Well, since I'm going to talk about all, initially all our HR tables, later we'll go into sales tables. So I've given a project name as development project, HR development project. You can give any name and then save this. Once you see here empty, so I'm just creating a project and clicking on save. Immediately you can see a project has been created in the left side, and when you expand, by default, lot of folders have been created. See, this is your first folder. Of course, this you can rename, remaining will cannot be renamed. And variable sequence, these are all we are going to develop as part of the ODI development. User functions, knowledge module, maybe if you remember, we spoke something about knowledge module long back, very high level. So that will be working over here. And when you expand this folder, you will find out package, mapping, reusable, procedure and all that. Okay, so anything, this is going to be our continuous activity and you will be sitting and spending time here, okay, all the time. So now, the smallest programming piece which you develop, if you go to Oracle, if you want to write a program, what do? You will write a PL SQL. If you go to Java, Java program will write it. And in the same way, in ODI also, the smallest program unit which we develop is called mapping. Generally, the same name will be there in Informatica also. The program which you are going to develop, it is like equivalent to PL SQL or Informatica mapping, data set, jobs or Java program, anything. So, the program which we are going to develop here in ODI is called mapping. What are we going to do in ODI? Finally, ultimately, read and load the data. In between, transform the data. So, in model, you have to place all the tables from which you want to read or load. So, that we have already done. Then, I need to go to mapping and then start developing this program. I think we need more 15 minutes backup time. Okay. So, out of all these things, we'll be slowly going one by one and our starting point will be mapping. So, to create a small program, so just right click this mapping and say new mapping. And immediately it will ask you, please give a name for your mapping. So generally the naming convention you can follow is M underscore. This is a simple mapping because we are going to develop a very small simple program. And then by default try to disable this option, create empty data set option. We'll see that later. Okay. Say okay. Okay, so this is your first screen, okay, you can see, and this thumbnails and all you can remove or you can minimize. So this is your actual designer and this is your actual mapping. And you will see lot of other things here. Slowly you will be learning one by one. So you can also rearrange whatever you want here and there. So what are the important components which we need to see? This is the first area, okay, where is playground, our playground. This is the place where we develop the code, design the code. And in the bottom, it will start showing the properties for everything which you place over here. So you will have three tabs here. And in the right side, you will find out something called components. So this entire list, whatever we have here, it is completely new in ODI 12C. This you will not see in older version. In ODI 11, and this entire episode will not be there. It is completely newly introduced in ODI 12C. Prior to that, it is not there. So this everything will be there. This is also same. And whatever mapping I am calling right now, this used to be called as a interface in older version, in 11. Maybe sometimes when you go for somebody suddenly may say interface, don't be concerned. Interface is a older word which is equivalent to the mapping now. Okay, so mapping, when I say older version interface. So if anybody calling as an interface also, don't be blamed, because that word comes from a historical background and people get used to that word and will say, that's why mapping or interface same. And the components is completely new. It is not really, was not there in older version. Rest all same. So now how to develop, it is very simple, because report ETL tools are meant for designing code in a graphical fashion. I don't need to write any or spend any too much brain here. Go to model and pick up from which tables you want to read and then specify onto which table you want to load. So now go and drag any table which you want to read or load. So I am taking this table and then dragging and releasing onto this place. అది ఎట్లా ఉండదు ఒక టాప్ చేయమని చెప్పి ఒక 5-10 minutes. I think can just 2-3 minutes will finish. I will continue tomorrow. That's, sorry for stopping in between. Tomorrow I will try to arrange. Not to get a break. I don't think it is getting started.